Hi, welcome back to ODE YouTube channel. Today I'm going to make another video of another short Caveco fountain pen. If you like the videos that I make, please don't forget to like and to subscribe the channel. And the pen I'm going to show you was sent to me by Caveco. And it comes inside this little black cardboard box that you've seen millions of times here in the channel. And when we take it out, it comes inside this plastic wrap, and here it is. This is the Caveco Frosted Sport Sweet Banana. It also comes with the usual little leaflet by Caveco with the story of the brand, the history of the brand, and the little sticker, silver sticker that I think I misplaced it right now. I don't know where it is, but I think you saw it sometimes, so I will get around that, and I had it here. I don't really know where I placed it. So, this is the pen. The pen came to replace the frosted line. It is a line with six colors, and it came to replace the former Ice Sport range. It costs 21 euros, so it's quite inexpensive. The pen, let's see the description of the pen, but you can check the overview that I made of the Caveco Frosted Sport collection, so you can see there all the details. But this is a pen with the Caveco Sport shape with chrome details like this. You can see there the logo of Caveco on the top of the pen, and it has 8-sided cap, and in one of those sides it says Caveco Sport. Then it has a cylindrical barrel with just a little minor step down that you cannot feel, that you cannot see but you can feel, and a knurled end, and beneath it has made in Germany. The pen and caps by screwing the cap or unscrewing the cap, and let's see how many turns. One and almost a half to unscrew, and then you have there the Caveco with the logo Caveco, and then the F beneath, very shiny nib, small number five nib, and there you have the feed with the Caveco Sport logo imprinted. There you have the threads that are not sharp, so you can hold it right there. And you have a place where you can put your international sized short cartridges. The pen, because it is it has threads and the threads are quite long, you can put some silicone grease and you can eyedropper this pen. Although this is not something that I would like to do, because I don't like to do that. But you can definitely do it, and you can see easily the ink level inside, because this is not transparent, but it is translucent enough to do it. So this is now, this has the small ink cartridge, small international ink cartridge, it's not eyedropper right now, and I never eyedropped the Caveco Sport before, but someday I may do it, because sometimes I have some questions about it. So, as I was talking, I was telling you, it has inside the short international cartridge, but it can take the Caveco short converters, and there are two types of converters by Caveco, the short ones. One is this. It has a metal collar there, and it says Caveco in this way there, and it is rubber, like an aerometric cartridge. You can fit that, but it is very hard to have a good feel. This one you can, this is the other one, which is like a piston, like a syringe converter. You can have a bigger feel, but You have more ink capacity if you use the ink cartridges. So these look very nice, and this is very nice to put into transparent pens, but into transparent versions of the Cavex Sport, but I don't really think they are a very nice thing to use, because you can't have as much ink as you have with the short international cartridges. But if you like, you can perfectly do it, and this looks great, in my opinion. Better than this one, but this also works. It all depends on the amount of ink that you like to put inside your pens. Now, I'm talking about some accessories, because I think I almost never talk about them, and it may be interesting. This pen comes without the ink converter, and it comes without a clip, but you can fit clips into this pen. And for this pen, you have two kinds of clip. You have the typical one, the modern one, and you have one that has a vintage style, that is the same as the vintage pens from Caveco. If you want to put one of these clips, you just slide it into your pen like this, so you can choose the cartridge, the clip, or if you prefer, you can put that one. No, the pen is not meant to put two. I was a little distracted, but you can put either of them, one or another, and it looks great. I think it makes a lot of sense for display. However, I almost never use a Caveco Sport with a clip on, but they are beautiful to see. They are available in some colors, black, chrome, gold colored, and bronze, so you have some things to choose. And now let's see some color comparison, because this is something that people find more interesting here with my Caveco videos. You have here the yellow Ice Sport, which has more of a neon greenish tone. This one came to replace that one, so this is the Ice Sport yellow. Then you have a beautiful one. This is the Caveco Art Sport Ametricine, which is a beautiful pen and made of acrylic, not ABS plastic. Then I have another pen that is an older one. This was an edition that was made for Spain some years ago, which is a yellow version. It is called Yellow Cab. It is one of the colors, one of the names for this color. This one is the older type of nib that has no breather hole, and it comes here, and it is a cooler tone than it looks here on the video. And finally, we have another. These are my yellow Caveco Sport pens, and this is the Caveco Sport, and this is called the Sunrise Sky. This is Caveco Skyline Sport Sunrise, exclusive edition for Fontoplume in Netherlands. And I don't know if you can see, it is a warmer tone of that yellow. There is still another one that I didn't put here, because it's not a different yellow, it's just another variation. It is the classic sport version of this one, which means it has gold plated details instead of chrome plated ones. And for size comparison, you know what's coming. It's always the same pens to compare. A Parker Centennial Lufol, this is the Citrine Czech color, and Lamy Safari. The Caveco Sport is much smaller, as you already know, but when we uncap the Lamy Safari, when we uncap the Parker Centennial Fold, and when we uncap and post the Caveco Sport, you will see that it is roughly of the same size, maybe even a little, just a little bigger. And this pen really is made to be posted. It is a pocket pen, and it is the motto of the Caveco Sport is small on the pocket, big in the hand because it really becomes a big sized pen. When you write with it and post it, it's not that long. For me, it is still okay to write with, but for people with bigger hands, it may slip here. Or if you hold the pen higher, it is not that comfortable. But if you post it, it posts quite deeply and still becomes a very large sized pen. So this is a good thing. It is not very thick, but the hour shaped section makes it comfortable to write with. Personally, I prefer broader section pens, but this one is really fine and I think we can write with it for a very long time. It is very light because it is plastic. And now let's see how the pen performs. And here we have our pen and paper, and let's start. This is the... It hard started a little because it was unkept for some time. This is the Caveco Frosted Sport, and the color is Sweet Banana, an interesting name for a pen. And the nib is a fine steel nib. The paper we are using is the usual Rhodia.pad, or Rhodia.pad if you prefer in English. And the ink I have inside is the Montblanc Lucky Orange. And this is really a beautiful orange that I cannot show that well here on camera because it looks more almost magenta or reddish, I don't really know. And so, let's see how the pen flows on paper. It has a very nice ink flow. It writes really well, even if you write faster. The nib is good. It is smooth, but you can hear it has some feedback. On camera, it looks much louder than it really is, and it is not unpleasant, but there is some feedback that you need to be aware. It is there. About the wetness, it is quite wet for a fine nib, so I think this is really good pen. It is a very good performer. Like this, the color shows more its real color than in when I'm writing normally. The pen writes well, no special nib, and on reverse writing it writes, it is a bit too thin on the paper and I don't really like the sound. It scratches a little, but it still writes. So it is possible to write and you will have a finer line width, but it's not very pleasant. About the line variation, there is no natural line variation with this nib, but you can try to force a little bit, but you will not have any, and it is not pleasant to force a fountain pen if you don't really need to. It becomes... You have a fountain pen because you want it to glide smoothly over the paper, and if you have to force it a lot, so what's the point of writing with a fountain pen? So this is not a flex nib. Although you can try to have some flex if you want for some moment, but the line variation is not really that big. And so this is all I had to show you about the pen. I have to thank you, Caveco, for sending me the pen. I thank you all my viewers for watching the video, and I hope to see you back soon here on the channel. So, see you next time. Bye.